Good morning, everyone. In order to mark the World Astronomical Week, today we are here to share with you some of the new discoveries and events which are happening in the area of space. Many of the universe's areas are yet to be explored, and continuous study and research is going on in various fields associated with it. This astronomical day is an occasion that is utilized to provide an opportunity to us to familiarize with the multiple facets of the universe. We are going to show you three recent discoveries with the science behind them. So we'll talk about the gravitational waves, discovery of atomic oxygen on Mars, and the new exoplanet findings of Kepler. So first, let's explore the gravitational waves. Although Einstein had proposed these waves long back in his times, these were discovered, or rather verified, only recently, 8 months back, and this discovery had soon hit the headlines. Einstein's mathematics showed us that massive accelerating objects would disrupt space-time in such a way that waves of distorted space would radiate from the source, which are like the movements of wave away from a stone thrown into a pond. These are none other than gravitational waves, which we shall explore in the following video.
Gravitational waves are considered ripples in space-time. What is space-time? Let's try to visualize it by imagining it as this blanket. Yes, we're compressing four dimensions into three. A smaller object on the blanket's surface doesn't change the shape all that much. It will just roll straight across. But if you place a bigger object with more mass on the blanket's surface, it warps the overall shape much more significantly and affects other passing objects. This is basically how gravity works in our universe. Objects seem attracted to each other, but really they follow the curvatures of space-time created by the presence of other larger objects. Now let's switch things up a bit. Instead of a blanket, imagine space-time as a pool of water. If you move an object through the pool, it causes a ripple effect outward. A similar scenario happens when large masses move throughout the universe. They produce gravitational waves that warp space-time. Everyone basically agrees that gravitational waves exist, but nobody has been able to prove them. In fact, the movement of every object in the universe supposedly produces these waves, but they're usually way too weak to be observed. So to find them, the scientists at LIGO looked for the biggest ones out there. That means observing two super dense black holes merging far away. This huge explosive event generates enormous waves.
This discovery was made by the LIGO. Precisely defined by Caltech, LIGO is a masterpiece of complex and sophisticated engineering. Super-stabilized lasers, enormous vacuum systems, the purest optics, unprecedented vibration isolation, and servo controls all work symbiotically for one singular purpose: to sense the ephemeral passage of a gravitational wave, which we'll see as follows.
Enter LIGO, the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory. This is a conceptually simple piece of kit that aims to measure the distortion in space-time caused by gravitational waves. LIGO works by splitting a laser beam and sending it in two directions. The beams travel precisely the same distance down long vacuum tubes. They reflect it off mirrors, and then they come back and recombine. The light waves of each laser beam are made to exactly line up so that they cancel each other out, and nothing will reach the light detector in the end. But if a gravitational wave passes through, it will minutely distort space-time, changing the distance each laser beam has to travel. That will mean that the waves no longer line up. They won't cancel each other out, and the signal will be detected. The experiment is hypersensitive to disturbances, and so two identical LIGOs were built on opposite sides.
So, first let's explore the gravitational waves. Although Einstein had proposed these waves long back in his times, these were discovered, or rather verified, only recently, 8 months back, and this discovery had soon hit the headlines. Next, we come on to the discovery of a more accurate amount of atomic oxygen on Mars. Notice that by atomic oxygen, we refer to the single atom of oxygen and not the elemental oxygen or O2 which is found on Earth.
Gravitational waves are considered ripples in space-time. What is space-time? Let's try to visualize it by imagining it as this blanket. Yes, we're compressing four dimensions into three. A smaller object on the blanket's surface doesn't change the shape all that much. It will just roll straight across. But if you place a bigger object with more mass on the blanket's surface, it warps.
Detecting atomic oxygen in the Martian atmosphere has been difficult in the past, such as on the Viking and the Mariner missions, because researchers weren't able to measure accurately the wavelengths associated with it. More precise measurements have been done by the SOFIA Observatory, or the Stratospheric Observatory for Infrared Astronomy, which you may imagine that it looks like this, but actually it looks.
One of the biggest challenges, of course, is we're putting a large hole in the side of the airplane.
The telescope in total is 17 metric tons, and there's an additional 3 tons distributed in electronic racks all over the aircraft.
The telescope has a certain level of precision. The instruments require a certain level of precision and accuracy in order to conduct the science. And the engineering challenge of providing that stability on an airplane that's flying.